I love this scripture. It's confusing. You see, there's a lot of theology behind why Jesus actually got baptized as he began his ministry. You see, because for us, baptism is a sacrament of initiation. It's a sacrament where we are cleansed from original sin. It's a sacrament where we are instituted into the church, the body of Christ. But Jesus is the body of Christ, and Jesus doesn't have original sin. So there's a lot of debate why Jesus got baptized. And the baptism that St. John was baptizing was the baptism of repentance of sin. So again, there's a lot of theories, theological theories, about why John the Baptist baptized Jesus. But I don't want to go into that. I will definitely do a podcast about this, Catholic Influencers podcast, because there's a lot of debate there. But I just want you to understand this. Why? What is Jesus trying to say here? What is the meaning of this for us today? You see, when Jesus came into this world, we were separated from God because of our sin. Now, Jesus comes into this world and he shows us who God the Father is. And all of a sudden, through the death of Christ, we are adopted as children of God. So you and I are now the beloved, the children of God. God the Father can now say, because of the death and resurrection of Jesus, not only to Jesus, that this is my son, my beloved, my favor rests on him, but now because of Jesus dying for you, because Jesus has adopted you as his daughter, as his son, these are the words the Father speaks to us. These are the words God the Father speaks to us in Jesus' name. These words, this is my son, this is my daughter, the beloved, and my favor rests on her, my favor rests on him. Now, in this, we need to understand the heart of God, the character of God. Because many of us, you see, don't pray. Many of us don't approach God. Many of us are afraid to have a relationship with God because we see God as someone who's there to judge us, to make sure that we're perfect. And unless we are perfect, then we feel uncomfortable in the presence of God. I hear this all the time, that people don't feel like they don't deserve God. They're not worthy of the love of God. Let me break this to you. First of all, one, you are not worthy of the love of God. But that doesn't matter. It's nothing to do with your worthiness, but it's everything to do with God's pursuit, the Father's pursuit of you, that he's madly and crazily in love with you. And he wants to have this relationship with you. Now, we cannot earn this love. We cannot work for this love. God is not going to love you anymore because you have been a week without sin. Or God is not going to love you anymore because you've given all your money to the poor. God's not going to love you anymore because you've been good. He's not Father Christmas. He's not Santa Claus. He is going to love you whether you've been naughty or nice. The only difference is when we are naughty, when we are sinful, we are often less able to receive the love of God because we step away from the grace of God, from the ability and the capacity to stop and to surrender to God. And so this is one principle, one thing we need to understand, that it is God's initiative. Love, the love of God, is God's initiative. What God asks of us is to stop, to surrender, to lift our hands up to the Father and just let him love you. This is the whole Christian gospel. It's nothing to do with your goodness. You see, it's everything to do with God's pursuit, with God giving us a hug. And once we are in that hug, that embrace, once we allow God to love us, then we will find the strength. Then we will find the joy and the peace we need to become the saints that God has called us to be. Then we will, like Jesus, be able to go out on mission to proclaim the gospel. Why did Jesus get baptized? Maybe, I don't know, maybe he needed to hear that voice from the Father. Maybe he needed to hear that the Father loved him. Maybe he needed that time of consolation with the Father so that he could go out knowing that he is loved by the Father. And we need that too. We need to know that we are loved. Otherwise, we won't have the strength to proclaim his love, to be the saints that we have a calling over our lives to be. And so this is my advice to you. I know this is strange, but I just want you, if you could, if you have a Bible at home, this is taken from Matthew chapter 3, verse 17. Okay, so there's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, the first gospel. If you have a Bible, dust off your Bible. Go and look for your Bible. And look at this. And go to verse 17, chapter 3, verse 17. And it says this. I've just read it at the beginning of this homily. This is my son, my daughter, the beloved, and my favor rests on him, on her. And I want you to read this, if you would, with your family. And by name, this, I would say, this is my son, Rob, the beloved, and my favor rests on him. And just imagine Jesus saying, imagine the Father saying that to you, because he loves you. But very often we're so busy, we're so distracted that we work for God, we try and follow God with allowing God to hug us, to love us. And so just sit with that scripture verse and read it. And if you're comfortable with doing that, highlight that in your Bible. Underline that. Or print it out. Whatever it takes. Just let the voice of God that was spoken to Jesus at the baptism, at his baptism with John, that is the same voice, the same words that are being spoken to you today. What you have to do is just stop and listen. Stop. And let God love you, because you are his beloved, and he has chosen you, and his favor rests on you.